Hello viewers, welcome to UNC Digital class. Today I am going to discuss on the second part of the relational model concept, that is relational calculus. So in this video lecture we will first differentiate in between relational algebra and calculus, then we will discuss different types of relational calculus, that is about tuple calculus and domain calculus. Okay, let's discuss the difference between relational algebra and calculus. For relational algebra and relational calculus, okay, relational algebra is a procedural query language and relational calculus is a non-procedural query language. Okay, it is a procedural query language. You can say this is a procedural query language, whereas the relational calculus is a non-procedural query language. That means, okay, it is a procedural query language and it is a non-procedural query language. Procedural query language means it specifies that how is to be retrieved the result, but non-procedural query language means what is to be retrieved for the result. Okay, that means in case of relational algebra there is some specific order of relational algebra operation, but in relational calculus there is no specific order for the operation of relational algebra. Okay, then next, it is a domain independent, but it is domain dependent. Okay, then next we will define the second point, that is it specifies how is to be, how the result is to be, how the result is to be retrieved. Okay, and it specifies what is to be retrieved. For the result. Okay, then next, it has some specific order, it has some specific order of operation, that is the relational algebra operation, but it has no specification, no specification for the operation. Okay, then it is domain independent. We can say the relational algebra is domain independent in nature. That means it does not depend upon domain of the relation, but the relational calculus is domain dependent. Okay, and next we can say this is like a programming language. This is the relational algebra like a programming language, but relational calculus is like a natural language. It's like a natural language. Okay, so these are the some points which differentiate between relational algebra. These are the some points which differentiate in between relational algebra and relational calculus. Okay, relational algebra is a procedural query language, whereas calculus is a non-procedural query language. In relational algebra, it specifies how the result is to be retrieved, what is the procedure, but relational calculus specifies what is to be retrieved from the result. Then next, it specifies some order of execution of operations, but it has no specification for the operations. Then it is domain independent. Relational algebra is a domain independent, whereas relational calculus is a domain dependent. And relational algebra is like a programming language and relational calculus is like a natural language. Okay. And next we will be discuss different types of relational calculus. Relational calculus is of two types. Okay. That is your tuple calculus, or you can say tuple calculus. Then second one is your domain calculus. Okay. First we will be discuss the tuple calculus. Tuple calculus is based on specifying the number of tuple variable in a relation. Okay, tuple calculus is based on specifying number of tuple variable in a relation, and you can say each tuple variable ranges over a particular relation. That means those tuple variables are used in the tuple calculus, those variables can ranges over a particular relations. Okay, and by using this tuple variable we can retrieve the result from a relation. Okay, then what is the syntax for tuple calculus, or what is the general form of a tuple calculus? The general form for the tuple calculus is, you can write T such that condition, or you can say this is the predicate. Then the general form for the tuple calculus, T condition T. T means here this T is the tuple variable. Okay, and condition T, it means it is a condition, or you can say a predicate. Okay. Okay. Then we will discuss some example on tuple calculus and what are the different forms of tuple calculus. This is called condition, or you can say this is called formula. Okay. So let me define what is formula. Formula means it made up of a predicate calculus atom, and a atom can be one of the following form. So first form is this is the first form, a form of the formation of a atom, that is RTI. Okay, here R means where R is the name of the relation, where the tuple variable TI is ranges, okay. And I already told you that TI is the tuple variable which ranges over the relation R. Okay, so let me discuss one example. First define a relation. Suppose there is a relation EMP having attribute F name, L name, SSN, birth date, age, salary and DNO. okay, and there is another relation. Suppose department having attribute D number, D name, D manager SSN. Okay, so these are the attribute, and here in case of employee relation, SSN be the primary key, and in the department table, suppose D number is the primary key. So let's see one example based on this atom. Suppose the query is given to find or retrieve the employee information, to find the employee informations. There is no condition, only have to find the employee information. For that we can write simply the relational calculus or the tuple calculus, that is T. T is the tuple variable, and we have to retrieve the employee information from the employee table or from the employee relation. So we will be mentioned according to the syntax, that is EMP T. Okay, it means T is the tuple variable which is ranges over the relation EMP, and this tuple calculus expression will generate the set of tuples from the employee relations. Okay, so this is the one form of the tuple, relational calculus atom. Okay, or the next form of the atom is an atom of the form, that is ti dot a op c, or you can write c op tj dot b. Okay, so in this atom form we define, that is where ti and tj are the tuple variable which are ranges over a particular relation. Okay, and next c is the constant value, c is the constant value. Okay, and op is the one of the, op is one of the comparison operator. Okay, and the comparison operators are less than, greater than, less than equals to, greater than equals to, not equals to. These are, and we can use any one of the operator instead of op. So let's see one example based on this atom. Suppose there is a query to find the employee information whose salary is greater than equals to 40,000. Okay, it means what? You have to find those employee information whose salary is greater than equals to 40,000. Okay, for that we will write the tuple calculus. Okay, so we have a tuple variable, suppose t be the tuple variable which ranges over the employee relation, employee, and the tuple variable ranges over this relation, and the condition is of this form. That means our tuple variable, that is t, according to this format or this form of the atom, we can write t dot a be the attribute of the relation. So here the condition is salary greater than 40,000. So we can write t dot salary. You can use the comparison operator, that is greater than equals to 40,000. Okay, that is 40,000. Okay, then what will be the this tuple relational calculus retrieve? It will retrieve those employee information whose salary is greater than equals to 40,000 from the employee information. And this is the expression for this query to find the employee information whose salary is greater than equals to 40,000. Okay. Next we'll see next form of the atom. An atom is of the form Ti dot A op, then Tj dot B. Okay. Ti, Tj are the tuple variable arranges over a particular relation, and A and B both are the attribute where the tuple variable Ti and Tj are ranges, and op with the any comparison operator. You can see where Ti and Tj are the tuple variable and op is one of the comparison operators, that is greater than equals to, less than equals to, not equals to, and A, B both are the attribute where the tuple variable Ti and Tj are ranges. Let's see some example on tuple relational calculus. Suppose there is a given query, retrieve the birth date age of the employee whose name is John Smith. Okay, that means you have to retrieve those employee birth date and age whose name is John Smith. So for that I can write the relational tuple calculus. Suppose T with the tuple variable which is ranges over the relation EMP, and we will be retrieve the birth date and age of the employee. For that I can write T dot birth date with the attribute of the employee employee relation, you can see, and T dot age. These two attribute will be retrieved, then employee relation where the tuple variable T ranges, and the predicate or condition for that employee relation is, the condition is the name is John Smith. Okay, so we can write T dot, that means the first name is John, so T dot F name equals to John, and T dot L name equals to Smith. The last name is Smith. Okay. That means those employee first name is John and last name is Smith, we have to retrieve that employee birth date and age. And according to the tuple relational calculus atom form, we have to mention the relation name where the tuple variable ranges, that is EMP T, and the second condition is T dot F name John. John be the, according to the condition, is the first name of the employee, and T dot L name, that is Smith, according to the condition, the last name of the employee. Okay, that means this tuple relational calculus will retrieve the birth date and age of those employee having first name John and last name is Smith. Okay. So next, suppose this next query is given to find the name and age of all employee who work for research department. This query is related to atom form number 3, and this query is relate two different relations, that is the employee relation and department relations. Okay. For that we will write the relational tuple calculus. We have to find out the name and age. Name means here, according to the relation, the name means that if name means the first name and last name. Okay. Suppose for employee relation we will using the tuple variable T. Okay. So I am writing T dot F name, then T dot L name. And next we will retrieve the age of the employee. So for that I can write T dot S. So these are the attribute information we have to retrieve from the employee informations. From the employee relations. Okay. Then what will be the conditions? So this tuple variable will ranges over the relation employee. So we have to mention T. Okay, and there exists another tuple variable D, which is ranges over the department relation. Okay, then our condition is we have to retrieve the name and age of all employee who work for research department. Okay, for that suppose I am writing that and D name, that is D dot D name equals to research and second condition is used to relate two relation, that is employee and department, and the attribute is your D number. Okay, in department table that is D number, in employee table that is DNO. Here we have to find that is the D dot D name equals to research. That means here we filter those tuples having department name research from department table, then we will relate this tuple with the employee relation. So for that I can write D dot D number equals to T dot DNO. Then after writing this condition, it will filter the first name and last name age of those employee whose department number is matched with the DNO. Okay, and this is all about your finding the name age of all employee who work for the research department. Next we will discuss the second relational calculus, that is your domain calculus. Okay, let's see the domain calculus from the relational calculus. So this differ from the tuple calculus in the type of variable used in the formula, and in case of domain calculus, rather the variable ranges over the tuple, the variable are ranges over the single value from the domain of the attribute, and this is the general form of the domain calculus. That is, these are the attribute variables or single variables, that is x1, x2, xn, which is ranges over this relation. Okay, this is a condition, or you can say this is a formula. Okay, then next we will see one example from the domain calculus. So this is the given example: retrieve the birth date and age of the employee whose name is John Smith. Okay, and that means here we have to retrieve the birth date and age. In case of domain calculus, we have to assign a domain variable to each and every attribute in the relation. Here in the employee relation, I am assigning Q variable to F name, L to L name, and accordingly W variable to D NO. Then in the department table, L variable to D number, and accordingly M and N variable to D name and D manager SSN. So according to our query, we have to retrieve the birth date and age, so that the birth date having variable T and age having variable U. So that I am mentioning T and U for retrieving this data, and there exists a, so that there exists a Q, R, S, V, W, and here this is the condition employee relation, and these are the domain variable of the employee relation. And condition is we have to retrieve those employee informations, those employee birth date and age whose name is John and Smith. John is the first name and Smith is the last name. For that I am using the variable Q for the first name and the variable R for the last name. So Q equals to John and R equals to Smith. Okay, that means those employee having first name John and Smith have to retrieve their T and U, that means birth date and age. Okay, then comes to next example: find the name and age of the employee who work for the research department. This example I already given in the relational tuple calculus, and this is based on the domain calculus, and this query will relate two relations, that is employee relation and the department relations. We have to retrieve the name and age, that means we have to retrieve first name, last name and age. The variable is Q, R and U. Here I am mentioning the variable Q, R, U, which is to be retrieved, and the condition is these are the employee domain variables and these are the department domain variables. Okay, the condition is the department should be research. For that I am writing aim equals to research, because aim is the variable which is representing D name in the department table. So that I am writing aim equals to research, and we have to relate these two table through the attribute D number in the department table and DNO in the employee table. So for D number we have domain variable L, and for DNO we have the domain variable W. So I am writing and L equals to W, that means D number equals to DNO. That means those employee having department research, you have to retrieve their department number, and we will match the department number from the department table with the employee D number, and those tuples are matched, then we will retrieve those tuples first name, last name and age of that employee. So this is all about your tuple relational calculus and domain relational calculus. Thank you. Have a nice day.